Good morning and welcome to another episode of Wedi Wednesday. This episode I want to dedicate to our Subliner Dry Sheet Membrane. Not only has our Subliner Dry Sheet Membrane been independently tested and passed the 4858 for waterproofing, it also has been tested through the ASTM E96 Method E for vapor proofing. Bear in mind that vapor is a totally different animal than water. So if you have an upcoming steam shower to do, please get in contact with us and we will guide you through the installation methods for that steam shower to make it 100% safe. The wedi Subliner Dry Sheet Membrane is made out of a 0.5 millimeter thin polyethylene film. This allows your consistent film thickness and no more variation in your waterproofing membrane. When applying the sheet membrane to your substrate, such as the bathroom floor, you need to make sure that your substrate is structurally rated, it is level, it is sound, and clean from dust and debris, oil, and waxes. After all this has been achieved, you're ready to adhere the sheet membrane to your substrate. By doing so, make sure you use the appropriate tile adhesive. For timber or wooden substrate, it might be a C2S2 tile adhesive. Please get in contact with us if you have any doubts. Make sure that the printed face is always going towards the direction upwards. Apply your tile adhesive to your substrate. First use your flat side of your notch drawer, key it in or burn it in. And then use a minimum of 6 millimeter by 6 millimeter notch drawer onto your substrate. Lay the sheet membrane onto the notches and flatten it out afterwards with a roller, a grout float or wooden float, for example. After this have been achieved, you're often facing still a seam into your sheet. Our rolls come in 30 meter length and 10 meter length, but also 1 meter width. So if you have a seam in a larger bathroom, you need to still apply our 620 joint sealant in between two seams. Bear in mind, the 620 joint sealant is a new joint sealant which has a lower viscosity rating, so it's not the same joint sealant what we use for gluing two boards together. You apply the 620 joint sealant into both seams, glue it together, and then you're virtually ready to tile. For further installation instructions, please look below in the comment. There we show you guys an entire installation videos of the Subliner Dry Sheet Membrane. Otherwise, I hope this was informal and I will see you next on Wedi Wednesday.
When planning for curbless showers, protecting the subfloor is a must. Properly waterproof and maintain a flush transition using Wedi's Subliner Dry Sheet Membrane. Use the channel protector strip included with the Lignel base and sealant 620 to fill the channel where the base meets the floor. If modifications were made to the base on this side, the channel does not have to be recut. When measuring the area for Subliner Dry, be sure to overlap the shower base a minimum of 4 inches and extend into the bathroom a minimum of 3 feet and up on walls in that area to protect drywall or seal to wedi wall paneling. When excessive water or splash off is expected, further extension of waterproofing is required. To stop excessive mortar overflow and maintain a proper seal, use tape to keep the edge of the subliner dry clean. This seam will be sealed later on with sealant 620. Mark, cut, and install the subliner dry with the directions facing up. Using a minimum 1/4 inch by 1/4 inch trowel, spread a wet area approved modified mortar onto your substrate. Use the flat side of the trowel first and use directional troweling techniques across the shortest length. This will ensure proper coverage and bond. Like with all wedi products, make sure the substrate is clean and free of debris before installation. Once it is set in the mortar, use a wood or mason float to compress the trowel lines and completely embed the subliner dry. When seaming multiple pieces of subliner dry together, maintain a 2-inch overlap between each connection. Keep this overlap free of mortar, as we will seal it with sealant 620. Remove any tape and clean any mortar that may have overflowed during installation. Use sealant 620 to adhere and seal the subliner dry overlap to the shower base. Flattening the sealant with a putty knife first will ensure a complete and even bond. Do the same to each 2-inch overlap. To properly protect the entire area, use Subliner Dry Sealing Tape to flash the waterproofing up the wall a minimum of 2 inches. This is a crucial step to stopping potential water migration through non-waterproofed areas of the room. Spread flat all excess sealant along every edge of the Subliner Dry, as well as the sealing tape with the Sealant 620, or apply more sealant to firmly embed the product edges.